This video explains the idea of buoyancy. And so let's say we have a box, which I've drawn here, and this box has a density of 400 kilograms per meter cubed. And it's floating in a fluid that has a density of 600 kilograms per meter cubed. And what we want to find is the submersion. This is actually a Newton's law problem in that the sum of the forces is going to equal the mass times the acceleration. However, since this box is floating, there is no acceleration, so the sum of the forces are going to equal zero. So the first force that we have is the buoyancy force, which is the mass of the fluid that's displaced by the object times gravity, which is the density of the fluid times the volume of the fluid displaced times gravity. So we can write this as the density of the fluid times the length and the width of the box times the amount that is displaced times gravity. In order for it to float, we balance that with the gravitational force, which is mg, which is rho vg. And this is going to equal rho of the box times the length times the width times the height of the box times g. And our height of the box is going to equal 6 centimeters. So we're only interested in the forces in the y direction. So we have the buoyancy force, which is upward, minus the gravitational force, which is downward. So this is going to equal zero. So our L, length, times our width, times our depth of submersion, rho sub F, G, minus, again, now we're talking about the box, the length, times the width, times the height of the box, times the rho of density of the box, times gravity equals zero. And as you can see, a lot of things cancel out, and we're left with, or depth of submersion is the rho of the box, or the density of the box, over the density of fluid times the height of the box, or 400 kilogram per meter cubed over 600 kilograms per meter cubed times 6 centimeters, which equals 4 centimeters.